child has not been born. Let me tell you what I'm talking about. I'm calling him behind. Why? Because he said, this generation will not pass away. This generation, that particular generation, 2,000 years ago, will not pass away until this whole thing concerning the coming of the kingdom will be fulfilled. What that simply means is not understand. In Jewish mythology, in their calendar, 2,000 years is a generation. He was born at the early part of that generation, that 2,000 years, which ended in the 2000. That was when he was born. I think 6 years into that generation was when he was born. And all of this happened, everything spoken that will take place prior to his coming, and all of those that were spoken, you know, post his coming, all cumulatively are enshrined in the book of Revelation, in which case, one of which is his return through birth, through the womb of a woman, which was born from the book of Revelation that we just read. So do not refer it to the Mary thing. Then it no longer be Revelation, because Revelation is more futuristic. Whatever has come and gone is no longer Revelation. Why you call it a vision is because it is futuristic and yet unknown. So that's why it is called Revelation, book of Revelation. This woman had conceived and had brought forth a man child, that's a man child that will judge the world. There is no other way that man child could have come. The Bible is very clear now of how it will come. Anyway, just go to Revelation 1:1. Revelation 1. Let's know the essence of Revelation. I've tried to buttress a lot of points, but let us listen to what Bible says regarding this book, Revelation. Future, is it future or is it past? It is what we are going to hear now from this book. The Bible, the Revelation itself, that will determine.
The revelation of Jesus Christ, which God gave unto him, to show unto his servants things which must shortly come to pass.
Things which must shortly come to pass, because it is 2,000 years. If you consider thousand and thousand and thousand and thousand and years that has gone by, and centuries, of course you can agree with me that 2,000 years, or 1,900 something years, because the kingdom came in the 20th century, in the 20th century. That was when the father was born, 1980. By 1950 something, he has established the kingdom already. 1954, so what that fulfills is that our Lord Jesus Christ knew what he was saying. That's why he says that generation will not pass away until these things manifest. If anybody says that the kingdom hasn't come, you are calling our Lord Jesus Christ a liar, that he has lied. Anyway, in so many ways, you know, most of them have called him liar. In so many ways, in every day, by their conduct, by beliefs, by everything they do, they are calling him liars. Like, to say the least, you know, when you say, when they misquote him, they are calling him liar. If you call him liar, because what that statement means is that that generation, that 2,000 years, which started from when our Lord Jesus Christ was born, continued until he ended in 1999. And by 1950, so by 1918, the Ancient of Days, the father, the one who he described in his figurative way of describing the way and manner the kingdom will be structured and the things that will happen therein. And he says, the kingdom will come like a man who desires to establish a wedding feast for his son, not for himself, for the glory of his son. And thereby sent emissaries to go and invite those people. Because they look at the man, that the man does not conform with their what they perceive to be their standard. He is not like them. He doesn't conform with them. But he wants them to come to be guests. For their own good, if we begin to analyze what those good we call me for their own. But because the world has been repackaged by Satan in such a way that you must be up to somewhere that will make people respect you, or will make you begin to attract respect from the public. And of course, God is not wired that way. He came in his numerology. The numerology of God, I challenge everyone now, please. Anybody listening to this or seeing this video, go and research the numerology of O. That is what O means in the mathematical world. Alpha and Omega, beginning and the end. Excellent God. All the qualities that attributed to God is what they say who is in numerology of God. So he came before the closure of that 20th century, just as our Lord Jesus Christ recommended and manifested the kingdom. And there is no other way, like I've always said, all of those could have happened naturally as everything evolved. As you set up your family and you know that you're calling it business, or those who are into a lot of things in life, they meaning that is what you came to do. Those who are kings came to be kings and all that. So yeah, in that way your destiny will drive you. That is what happened in his own case. The difference between you and him is that from the childhood, from the youth, from whom he knows himself. That was why when they sent him to school, his parents sent him to school. Let me tell you why he even accepted to go to school. He has, more children. Do not disobey your parents. Obey your parents so that their days will be long. That is why he obeyed his parents and went to school when they wanted to go to school. But when he got to school, God teachers knew that this person cannot be taught. And the same day, they spared him from the school. How can you be correcting teachers? How can a little child be correcting teachers? Before teachers start writing, he asked, hey, there is a mistake somewhere, man. Sir, please. That was what the teachers were saying of him before the night they spared him. And as he grows like that, he knew that he came to teach. And he told the whole of Biakman, including the teacher, they should call him teacher. That is what he came to do, to teach people a new way of life, a new way to live in harmony with the spirit that is coming after year 2000. He came to sensitize the world on how to live in order to conform with the standard of a new kingdom that is coming, and to be in harmony with the judgment of the king of that spirit, that kingdom, the spirit that has that kingdom that is coming, who is coming, not only coming to judge the world, is coming to judge the universe. So, in a way, to bear witness, he has to come. That is why the Bible was very clear. When he shall come, he shall teach you all things. Just like in my humble way, he taught me science in different branches. He taught me scripture. He taught me everything that everybody, a normal man, need to know in order to stand tall in this global stage. He taught me everything without me learning from anybody. So that is who he is. Then he will be clothed in flesh while doing all that work, while establishing the kingdom, while doing the assignment of teaching, while he's doing all of those that he's assigned to do by Lord Jesus Christ. He will not come in any other form except the form of a man. That is the only way we can accomplish this, because the mission has to do with men amongst men. And let's go back to science. In the science of God, which everything you see in the world called science happen to be counterfeit with the things God has orchestrated, everything God has kept, they counterfeit it. Let me begin to enumerate. Plane is likened unto bird or shark. There is a human, a natural technology invented by God that is navigable in the aquatic world. There is a natural technology invented by God with consciousness, limited consciousness, that navigates from one decision to the other in the aquatic world. There are birds likened on the aeroplane that flies from one destination to the other. That was how they got the impetus to deploy the laws of nature that will ordinarily function that way, because that is how God kept it, through the invention of the originality of those technologies which he gave life. Because there are things like that, the Western Spirit, that are made by God. That is why they are able to, you know, artificially invent it. It is all boiled down for us not to completely harness the energy of God that is lavishly, you know, deposited everywhere. The energy with which they apply scientific mechanism to achieve all of these things, I have mentioned it before, it's called electromagnetic. It fluctuates between negative and positive. So, there is no other way that could have happened. That was why, as it happened in the pagan world, all they did was to manipulate us, you know, trickishly, trick by trick, from Babylon. The Jews, you know, were wooed into it. Generations later, in Rome, when the pagan world had perfected an arrangement for God to sit like, for Satan to sit like God and be worshipped, they had perfected it. The plan was hatched in Babylon. From that very first time, they made the Jews begin to worship their God. What we did was worshiping of the day Satan was born. That is what has happened a few days ago. Worshiping of Satan. So the world think they are worshiping God, and they are worshiping Satan. The truth of the matter is that is why there is no progress. That is why there is no unity. That light of sun the deity that governs there will continue to fragment us, continue to divide us, you know, because you see, when energies, look at what the youth were able to do. For the very first time, Nigerian youth came together to speak in one voice. Look at what we're able to do. Can you imagine what would have happened if that has stretched for 1 week? The government would have been on its knees. That is what collective energy can do. If you can do that in physical, then you should understand the magnitude in the spirit. So, the woman having incarnated and had brought to manifestation a child destined to establish the temple of God, which was meant to die for. That birth happened on the 30th of December 1918. Those are days, and I have said, I would like to emphasize, those are days that are worth celebrating. 28th of November, 10th of July, and 30th of December, yesterday. Those are the days that are worthy of being celebrated. All of the ritual that happened by the pagan world, all the years, all the ritual they've been doing, they are doing it waiting for 38. So that is the day the universe radiates energy that sustains or energizes the whole universe. How it comes here in form of material well-being, that is how it comes here. I have said, also said here in this platform, that the way children of God are cheated over is because of how we are tricked to be in the background of the celebration without knowing what it is all about. And that being part of the ritual, which is the foundation of what we must do in order to prosper. And yet, we join to celebrate that God, able to eat all the blessings of those who celebrate that. And then, blaming Mother Earth and principalities of darkness. Just like as you see, President, State, Governor, and Mother, that is how, you know, the order is. Take the quantum that will sustain the empire in control, because everyone will give him the job. Those who will be left to their feet are those who don't even know what is happening. So, this God that has come, one important thing, because everybody wants to see here, how does it affect their material well-being? Material well-being. That is what man is after. He is the one, the moral ethic and principalities of darkness, who have created that purpose for us. So that everybody will be on the first day. So that everybody, and the manipulated society, like I have always said, there is this competition tendencies. Everybody tends to compete with everybody. Everybody tends to look down on each other. And under that influence, people tend to live in life. And tend to walk in slam eye. In that mood of being in a hurry to meet all it takes to please the world, there is no time for you to know hidden things. No time. You live a shallow life. Many ends up that way. Life doesn't like many. But we thank the same God for what he's doing now in the spirit. Olumba, Olumbo, who is in the spirit now. All these multitude of people are dying. All the people dying now. Like you see, people dying from the coronavirus. Many, I can guarantee you this. The death is not bad one. They are going to be cleansed. They are going to be washed so that they can come and be in his kingdom. He kept them. Churches thought there are people who barricaded them. What barricaded, the truth of the matter is that what barricaded men from invading brotherhood, like I said, like before, when Constantine hijacked Christianity, everybody went the way of Christianity because big man. So if the world have knew whom we are with. People who are better than you and I will go and occupy this space. He doesn't want it that way. He used this blasphemy and all these things that they're doing. That is why those who had attained his knowledge through their attainment of the enabling esoteric degree, there is a degree you attain in that cosmic intelligence. You will know your environment. You will know what is occurring in the world spiritually. You will know. Those categorical people have known that the number is God, but they are not they are not worthy of him because of the what they are into. They had, a lot of them had made several covenants due to quest for power, quest for fame. They have made covenant with a lot of gods, and they doesn't like anybody. Anybody who is standing on two tables that are with him, that person is very lucky. It is 90% chance that when you're on two tables, you will not agree to come to him. You will not agree. Even those that have known consciously that this is God Almighty that cannot be defeated in battle, they still will not come. One, they know what to do in darkness with the principalities that are in alliance with them, which they believe have made them unworthy of coming to him. I have said it here and now for some of them who is talking onto this video. The door is not foreclosed for you. He said whatever sin, no matter the multitude, he is going to wash it away of you and make you his son once again.